Everyone, DFG here. Hey guys, do you have your ticket? No problem. Just click the subscription button below and then come on in. But hey guys, anyway, DFG here. Hey, this is going to be a short video, and I really mean it this time. You know, I was in a conversation just recently and with a white person, Caucasian person, and this person said to me that the reason why blacks, so-called black people, meaning copper-colored Native Americans, so-called black people, the reason why black people don't embrace homosexuality is because of the Bible. Because black people believe in the Bible and black people go to church, and that's why black people, as a whole culture, not, you know, some culturally speaking, as an ethnic group, that they don't embrace homosexuality because of the Bible. Well, let me set the record straight for you. First of all, that's bullshit, because people of color, you know, don't embrace homosexuality as a whole community, as a group, because many people of color, myself included, see it as a perverted act. Simple and plain. We see it as an act of perversion. Now, we don't judge people in the black community in terms of if they embrace homosexuality or not. In other words, we don't go out and, you know, we don't go shoot them. We don't go jump on them. And, you know, we don't have hate groups inside of the black community that go out looking for homosexual men or women, you know, to physically harm them. Because at the end of the day, we respect their right, you know, to have the right. But in terms of marginalizing us as a group of people because of the Bible or somehow or another, we're so God conscious. That, you know, we think, you know, we don't have a mind, an independent mind, to be able to discern what's in the best interest of us as a people, or what's not in our best interest, except that we have the Bible, you know, the book, to help us discern that is disrespectful. It's insulting. It marginalizes us as an ethnic group. As a people who can think logically, critically, and independently. You know, again, I don't want to take you down the road of how this Bible came into our possession. I'm talking about Native African, Native Aboriginal people, copper color people. The Bible that we read from, the one that you're familiar with, matter of fact, this one, okay? This was brought to us by Englishmen, people who look a lot like white people. And that was told to us that we should submit ourselves and that we should look for heaven when we die, and we should pray for a better day as long as we obeyed our masters right here. Well, let me make this real, real clear to you. The days of obeying masters is long gone. And secondly, the days of, you know, white feeling like they can determine how black people think is long gone. If you want to know us, take the time and learn about us. Study. Go back and go through and look at real history. If you want to know us and be able to have an informed opinion about us. Other than that, shut the hell up. Because all we know about you is what you taught us about you. That's all we know about you, is what you taught about us, and obviously what you do. Okay? So all you know about us is what you learned about us, which, for the most part, is absolutely nothing. So please don't try to size us up or figure us out or make assumptions about what we believe or what we don't believe or what's good for us or what we think is good or evil. You have no idea. Now get out of your feelings and deal with it. Thank you for listening. DFG. Bye now.